We've got updates on auto park, the automatic windshield wipers, the pricing for full self-driving, and a whole lot more coming up on this episode of Tesla Tweets. Stay tuned. Hey, what's up everyone? Jeff here from Pure Tesla. Great to see you on another episode of Tesla Tweets. Now, before we get started, something super quick right here. I thought it'd be kind of fun. You know, we talk about the Tesla cam drives on every episode, probably getting a little dull at this point, but I thought it'd be kind of fun if I hit a code somewhere in this episode. It's only going to show up super briefly, so you're going to have to pay really close attention. The code's going to be for 50% off any one of our Tesla cam drives. They all come pre-formatted, ready, plug and play, right out of the envelope. Right into your Tesla. 50% off, the code will be somewhere hidden in this video. Good luck, first person to use it gets that 50% off. Here we go, on with the show. So Tesla owners of Silicon Valley asks Elon, any updates on AutoPark? Elon responds that we're working on a simple initial version of AutoPark. It'll be safe, but sometimes park in silly places that aren't actually parking spaces. So, you know, we knew that the first initial launch of AutoPark probably wasn't going to be great, but at least we know it's going to be safe. And of course, with all that neural net information going back to Tesla, it'll only continue to get better. In a tweet from Milo to Elon, he asks, please make the wipers faster in auto mode. It takes too long, like to the point that they're useless. Thank you. Elon responds, okay. And then it gets into a conversation about auto mode in general in terms of windshield wipers. Somebody else says, needs to adjust the sensitivity of the wipers. It's very late response to the rain when left in auto mode. Software updates keep messing with the wipers and the low and high beam light sensitivity, actually. Please take a look into it. Not that it's very important, just something to look into. Thank you. Elon responded that deep rain, trademarked, neural net coming soon. We're not trademarking any other autopilot neural nets, just this one, because rain is deep. I think that's pretty funny. Anna on Twitter responded to Elon, tweeting that he noticed great improvements with the rain neural net in the few months back. It was reverted with the general release of version 10. Is this deep rain? Elon responded that it's actually called deep rain as sort of a joke at Tesla. It takes a surprising amount of deep learning to know when and how fast to move the wipers based on the amount of rainfall. So that's kind of where the name came from. Not sure if the trademark thing is actually true or not, but kind of cool. And deep rain is coming and should be an improvement to your auto wipers. In response to the auto wiper conversation, Steve on Twitter asks, it must detect wet and icy surfaces also, right? And will this algorithm be used to adjust the speed of the car depending on the weather? Elon responded simply, yes. To switch gears, Purple Model 3 on Twitter asks Elon, any chance that we can get the white loading screen on the web browser to change something darker at night? It's blinding when loading Tesla Waze on a dark road. Elon responded, yep, good catch. So be looking out for that in an upcoming software update. Tesla Roddy on Twitter tweets out an article of theirs stating that Tesla's bioweapon defense mode is providing invaluable once more amid California's wildfires. Certainly all of our thoughts are with you in California that are battling those wildfires. But Elon retweeted this, and it's been an ongoing thing that the filtration systems, most particularly in the Model S and X, with bioweapon defense mode, are just proving to be invaluable and a great asset to owners with the decreasing air quality due to all the smoke and the wildfires. In a pricing conversation about full self-driving, Elon tweets out that now that Tesla version 10.0 with Smart Summon is out, the full self-driving price will increase by $1,000 on November 1st. It gives owners and new owners approximately 2 weeks or so to get their orders in through the Tesla website for that full self-driving package before it goes up an additional $1,000. Anna again gets another response from Elon in that same conversation when he asks, when can we get an upgrade to hardware 3.0 from 2.5? Elon responded that they're working with the engineering team right now to develop a plan that won't crush Tesla service, which is great. And more widespread upgrades will be taking place in the next couple of months, which will be coincident with additional features being released in full self-driving. In response to this conversation, Frank asks Elon, will the increase to the full self-driving price also happen in France, given that France is not able to use some of the full self-driving options, namely Smart Summon? Elon responds that that's a fair point, and they'll hold on EU price changes until Tesla gets clarity from regulators about the Smart Summon feature release date. So they will be holding back on the $1,000 increase for the areas that has not seen Smart 7 come to those full self-driving packages yet, but do know that it is a still a reality for the places that have Smart Summon already. Clean Technico tweets out an article about Tesla Smart Summon chasing kids. Elon responds that several finesse improvements will be coming to Smart Summon in the coming weeks, and it will be smooth as silk. So looking forward to seeing additional improvements. I can't imagine how much data Tesla has collected from the hundreds of thousands of Smart Summons that have taken place since the feature released. And I'm sure all of that data will make for a much more improved Smart Summon experience. In an interesting statement about pricing and what original early adopters should be receiving, at least early adopters of the Model 3, Bruce on Twitter tweets to Elon saying, "Please consider giving all us early adopters who paid more for our cars basic autopilot or adaptive cruise without having to pay an additional $3,000. Why should someone who bought a Tesla in 2019 get this included, while someone who bought it in 2018 at a higher price have to pay $3,000 more?" Elon responded very candidly, and something I appreciate, "Tesla cannot continue to lose money. Bottom line. To achieve our goal of environmental sustainability, Tesla must be financially sustainable or they will cease to exist." So, I guess when you put it that way, is it better to have Tesla or your $3,000? So, I guess we'll see where that goes. Luis Ramirez on Twitter asks Elon a good question. "How will your goal of making the most affordable electric car for the masses be achieved if over the long run, the cost will continue increasing as full self-driving continues to improve?" Now, Elon responds to this by stating that when the car is full self-driving without supervision, like a robo-taxi, for instance, you'll be able to earn far more than the monthly lease or loan option by allowing others to use it. Basically, managing a small fleet of robo-taxis will be a career for many people and much better than driving a single car. So the cost benefit is much greater when you utilize your vehicle in a way in which Elon is preparing robo-taxi, for instance. Wilson on Twitter asks Elon, "Any word on when Navigate on Autopilot for street level, aka traffic lights and signs, will be out?" Elon responds with a winking emoji. There's some speculation as to what that means. Is a release imminent? Is that just his fun way of responding? It might coincide with the November 1st price increase. You might see additional features release, and that might be a good thing that sparks additional people to upgrade to that full self-driving component. We'll see. But what's your thought? Maybe leave a comment below as to what you think that winking emoji means in response to that question. Mandeep on Twitter asks Elon a Canadian-related supercharging question. "Any plans to add superchargers along the Ontario routes in Canada?" And Elon responds that they will be throughout Canada, and so additional superchargers are coming. Stay tuned, Canada. Vincent on Twitter states that he's going to order the pickup truck at the unveiling event next month. Can't wait. Elon responds that it is something special, and so I'm super excited to hear more about that. He keeps calling it the Cybertruck, so I think it's going to be something unique and something that a lot of people will love and a lot of people probably won't love, but will probably also come around to over time. So definitely excited to see that take place and what comes of the Cybertruck release. Steve Jobs Ghost, friend of the show, states that in the future, the settings for your driver profile will be stored in the cloud on your Tesla account. And not only will this allow you to use any phone as a full backup for your center touchscreen, but also you can log into any Tesla or robo-taxi and download all your preferences. And Elon says exactly. So that's something cool that might be coming in the near future. In another supercharging tweet, Elon tweets out that all Tesla supercharger stations in regions affected by California power outages will have Tesla power packs within the next few weeks, just waiting on permits. Additionally, they're adding Tesla solar to all of their supercharging stations as fast as possible. The goal is 24/7 clean power with no blackouts. This is huge news for those of you in California that are always skeptical as to when you're going to get your next charge. And the superchargers are going to keep up with that demand based on what Elon tweeted out here. George on Twitter asks Elon, "Any news regarding the upgrade for the MCU1 cars? Still no karaoke for my 2017 Model X." Elon responds that they're working on it. Alex on Twitter, in a note to Elon, states that non-autopilot cars are still in the loaner fleet, by the way. Elon responds that he'll remove those. So look to see only cars that have autopilot in the loaner available fleet moving forward, which is great news too. Anner gets a third response from Twitter this week, When he asks, is the pedestrian speaker retrofittable? Elon responds that it's not easy as it requires wire harness changes. Alex on Twitter says, OMG, I'm dying over here when he sees how that Easter egg about Monty Python is built in to the naming convention for your Tesla. Elon responds with the laughing, crying emoji. It's an awesome set of Easter eggs. We'll link to that down in the description for you to see all of them, but this is certainly a good snapshot as to what you can experience. Elon tweets out that prototypes are easy, but achieving volume production of any new technology is insanely hard. Elon responds to himself, actually, when he states that Tesla is the first American car company to achieve sustained volume production in the last 100 years. The hardest, most painful thing he's been through, including getting the Falcon to orbit. So quite an undertaking here, and major props to Tesla and Elon for pulling off something that hasn't been done in 100 years. Pretty amazing. Elon goes on to state that he has so much respect for those doing high volume manufacturing. It's insanely hard, but you make a real thing that people value. My hat is off to you. Everyday Astronaut responds to that, stating that, I take it you're soaking in the feels about Gigafactory 3. Are things going well there? Are cars rolling off the line yet? Elon responds that the Tesla team has done an incredible job with Giga Shanghai, and he's honored to work with them. I'm in awe. So things must be going along quite well there in Giga Shanghai. Looking forward for additional updates on that. Tesla Roddy tweets out an article about how the Tesla Model S P100D Plus plaid trim level has actually met its match with the Nürburgring once again. It's sporting a refreshed wide body with a massive rear diffuser. You can see the picture on the side here. Elon responds to that tweet, stating that the final configuration used at the Nürburgring to set the record will actually go into production around summer of 2020, and that it's not merely just for the track, but we'll actually see these things on the road. Pretty amazing there. And Elon tweets out in the most recent tweet that Tesla wins the Best Headlights Award, tops the list for the IIHS Best Headlights in its class. And I would agree that of any car I've driven, man, I can just see anything when I'm on the road in my Model 3. That'll wrap up this week's episode of Tesla Tweets. Certainly had a great time going through all of the Tesla news with you. Did you find the coupon code? If you did, certainly head over to puretesla.com and enter that in after you've added the product to the cart. If you're the first person to find the code, you're going to enjoy 50% off of your purchase on anything that we have in there. Super cool. And also, if you didn't, there's always drives available for you at puretesla.com as well. Until next time, I hope you have a wonderful week, and we'll see you then. Take care. Tesla Roddy tweets out that the